All right, on this episode of Bouts Talking Bouts, we have quite the intriguing fight going down on January the 14th. One heavy hitters and the main event attraction for the one strawweight championship takes place between Xiong Jing Nan and Ayaka Miura. And very happy to have Xiong on the show. How's Xiong feeling in the lead up to this fight on Fight Week?
今年现在已经这个礼拜要打比赛嘛，这礼拜心情如何啊？一切都还好吗？一切都还好，身体包括心情状态。
Yeah, I feel so good. I'm in my best shape, and my whole condition is good. So yeah, I feel good. I'm looking forward to this fight on Friday night.
Yeah, and I was noticing there's actually a Fight Week birthday in there as well. It seemed like January 12th there from what I was seeing. So happy early birthday there.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that. Oh my God. Hi, Jing Nan. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Thank you so much. No.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow. Jing Nan said that her birthday is
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Yeah, no worries. Just a very interesting time for a birthday. And it seems like the Miura KO is kind of in the proverbial crosshairs there. Would that be the ideal birthday present there, getting a knockout victory in defending this title?
这一次的生日，因为刚好你的生日就在这个礼拜明天嘛，那对来说最好的生日礼物是不是就是把他 KO 掉，然后还保持这个台词，KO掉他拿下比赛，再次卫冕。 Yeah, it's knock it out and keep my belt with me. That is my best birthday present, of course.
Yeah, and just such an incredible run you've had as champion. I kind of wanted to talk about just, you know, one Empower as well before getting into this fight here. Just being such a history-making event and being in a headline fight, getting the victory there. Like, what did that moment feel like, just being part of such a history-making event, but being the headline attraction on that event?
You mean Empower event, right?
Yeah, Empower, yeah, with the Nicolini fight.
Okay, 竟然就上次那个你跟Nicolini打那一场，你是头条主赛，而且就是很难得，就是那个全女子战卡那一张九月的比赛，然后对你来说，这个意义的重要性在哪里？
而且你去头条，主要性是因为这就说明了赛事和老板所有人对我的一个认可，也是莫大给我的一个鼓励和支持，让我更有动力的继续往前进，往前行。I
have to say that I appreciate Chachi and the whole one championship. Put a female belt on the headline. I think it's a history because I don't think, as far as I recall, I don't think there is any female headline as well with the whole female card, you know. So I think it's got. I think that it's because they know that the female power, the women power in MMA is rising. So that's why they do it. And I'm the one, I'm Xiong Jing Nan, the one they chose to put on the headline. So yeah, it's I defend my belt. So it's a big legacy to me. So yeah, it's my motivation to push me forward to any kind of fight, any kind of difficult I'm gonna face.
And something I was curious to ask about, because in the Empower post-fight presser, there was a moment I was talking about in the first round where Nicolini seemed rocked but didn't quite get finished, and Jing Nan was describing that situation as, you know, she said she put the happy strikes on her. She's like, oh, I have a very kind heart, but next time I'm going to be very aggressive. Is that something you can prepare for in a training camp to, I guess, you know, not put the quote happy strikes on her and be especially aggressive? Is that something you can train for, game plan for, etc.?
竟然因为在那个尼科尼那一场比赛的时候啊，就是那一次你没有终结他嘛，那其实可能在前面几个回合之后，其实你很有机会可以终结他的，但是你却没有终结他，所以感觉你打不是那么的积极。所以你现在回想起来，或者说你现在做准备的时候，有针对就是可以快速终结这一块，有做比较特别的准备吗？还是说你是这是你新的打法呢？其实对很多人来说，他可能不理解当时我为什么有那个反应。其实，抛开比赛来说，对于我个人来讲，我其实是很尊重尼科尼尼的。
因为很多人都称他为老师，虽然呢，我和他，虽然没有教过我课，但是我也是从内心一直以来就非常尊重的，毕竟他也以前也是Evolve的老教练，所以我的尊重会比较多一点，可能在上场比赛中就欠缺了那么一点点的那种狠的那个打法，你懂我的，你能理解我的意思吗？
我懂你的意思。
我知道他的。 所有人都知道他的地面有相当的好，也所有人认为他可能会在地面终结我。但是对于我来讲，我更多的是尊重，就是以这场比赛正常的拿下就行。我其实蛮不想让他受伤的。Yeah.
Okay, I know that a lot of people said that I don't have the heart to finish Nicolini in that Impel event, but I have to tell you that a story I have not. Told everyone in the post-fight interview. The reason why I didn't finish her is because I respect Nicolini a lot. She's a BJJ expert, and she's so senior. She's a senior fighter than me, I think. And she has been teaching ground fight in Evolve in the gym. She has been a coach there, so I respect her a lot. So that's why I don't have the heart to finish her. So I go to the whole round, you know, the five rounds. So I think it's a kind of my way, my Xiong Jing Nan's way, my special way to show my respect to my opponent, to Nicolini.
I mean, that's fair enough when it's laid out in those kind of terms. And it seems like the respect for a lot of people within that Evolve MMA team is pretty pronounced. Obviously, yourself being an instructor and everything like that. But it seems like there's a strong bond there with, you know, Alex Silva, for instance. I kind of wanted to get some specifics on that because I imagine that's a huge iron sharpens iron kind of thing, working with someone who also used to be a one strawweight champion in the male ranks.
Okay, Alex Silva training, right?
Yeah.
OK, 那之前，因为之前其实有跟那个，你知道 Alex Silva 吧？就是，对对对，不好意思，我不知道他中文名是什么，就是有跟 Alex Silva 一起做地面的训练嘛？那你觉得跟他一起做地面的训练，有就是让你有成长嘛？然后你觉得对你来说获得的好处在哪里？在那一场比赛里面，在跟Nicolini那场比赛里面。
其实我一直很感谢 Alex Silva， 因为我们俩都是在相互的帮助。毕竟在，就比如说他有比赛的时候，我也是一样在陪他去备战、打实战什么的都会，每天都会陪他训练。然后在这个过程中，教练教会了我曾经不曾懂的一些技术，而且我在备战中。 因为是正好在我和利克尼尼打的时候，我们那种备战中是最困难的时候，吉姆不能开，然后只可以两个人训练，就是我和陪我训练的人只可以两个人，而且吉姆没有开，我们只用了九块垫子这个样子。其实让我受益匪浅的是，他教会了我很多我曾经不懂的一些技术，或者我不熟练的一些技术，而且在这场比赛中，其实他帮助了我很多，毕竟包括我的 defense。 已经提高了很多，大家也可以看得到，利克尼尼在take down我的时候，并没有把我给怎样。嗯，OK，所以你刚刚讲的教练就是那个
Alex Silva， 对不对
？Yeah, yeah, yes.
好 ，OK， I greatly appreciate Alex Silva. He's an amazing coach, amazing ground fighting game coach. We have been helping each other for a long time because when Alex Silva have a fight. I will prepare with them. I will sparring with them. So we're sparring with each other for a long time. And when in my training camp for Empower, it's a very hard time. That period, it's a very hard time in Singapore because of the pandemic. The gym is closed. And only when you do sparring or do a training, only two people can together do a sparring and do a training. It's so hard. And you can find a gym, you can find the right place to do the whole training. And when you have to do the ground fighting, so ground fighting practice, I only had nine matches on the ground to practice it. So it's so hard, it's such a hard time. But I have to say that Alex Silva really teaches me a lot. He teaches me a lot of skills I have not known before, especially on takedown defense. Now I think I improve a lot on my takedown defense. Like you can see in my last fight with Nicolini, she cannot drag me down to the ground, and I can stop a takedown attempt. So yeah, it's a great coach. I appreciate him.
Yeah, well, those improvements she was talking in the Nicolini fight about not being able to get taken down to the mat, I imagine would pay huge dividends in a fight with Miura, who's very centric on, you know, the jiu-jitsu techniques and whatnot. Is that a fair characterization? Like, does Xiong Jing Nan feel, you know, quite prepared facing someone like Nicolini and segueing into fighting someone like Miura, who's also very submission-centric?
OK，那像一次你跟那个尼孔妮妮打的时候，他也是地面很强嘛，他是BJJ很强。那这一次你跟那个三浦彩佳打，他是柔道很强。你觉得这两个人，就是你准备起来会有不一样吗？觉得准备三浦彩佳会比较难吗？会比较简单吗？也不是这样的。然后是很多人可能认为啊，三浦彩佳会怎样怎样。其实我并不是这样认为。你要知道，每一个运动员都有他一样，任何人比不上他的一个。一个东西，所以对于三浦彩佳来说，他有他自己的一个非常独特、非常厉害的一个技术。所以在备战的过程中，和尼克妮妮相对来说是有一点点的不同啊。但是同时，我也有在地面，不管摔跤也都有进行更强烈的一个去备战。
Maybe a lot of people will say that it's gonna be an easy fight for me because Miura-san, she's only ranked like number 4, not like Nicolini. She's a BJJ master. But we have, you know, that Miura, she is a judo. She got a judo black belt. So judo is her special weapon. And everyone knows she got a very famous trademark that is a shoulder lock. I have been preparing how to break her shoulder lock in my camp. So, and I have been preparing a lot of grappling and wrestling this time. So I don't think it's going to be an easy fight. I will do my best. I will be well prepared for this fight.
Oh, for sure. And I wasn't trying to say that it was going to be an easy test necessarily, just maybe the stylistic similarities between opponents. I mean, I know Miura is someone who is a new contender. This doesn't represent a rematch, putting some wins together. So yeah, definitely a good quality opponent here. I imagine one Zhang has been looking at for a little while, a good opponent to notch for the sixth defense here. But I also kind of wanted to talk about the broader timeline with it being, you know, 4 years as of January 20th. Like, does that timeline mean something to Jing Nan? Like, is that a hugely important milestone?
OK， 所以那个，既然因为其实你这么久以来打过很多不同类型的选手嘛，那你看你都已经打过这么多不同类型的选手，那这一次的话，那个三浦彩佳是一个柔道厉害型的选手，你觉得对你来说的话，这么多不同类的选手，在你的这个运动员的这条，而且是捍卫冠军腰带这条路上，有什么样的意义？
它促使我越来越强，也促使我从一个单一的一个运动员变成了一个各项都非常强烈的运动员。可能很多从第一开始认识我就感觉认为我应该是一个 boxing 和 teaching 战力型的一个运动员，但是我会让更多的人能够看到我不仅是在战力方面，在地面还摔跤，我都有更多的进步，而且我让别人能够知道我完全成了一位真真正正的 MMA 综合格斗的一个冠军，而且还是世界冠军。
Everyone who can step into the ONE Championship circle to fight against me, everyone is top fighter, you know, because this is a global stage. You have to be top to fight. You have to be a top athlete to fight in ONE Championship. So I like to fight. I like to challenge every different fighting style. I like to challenge every top fighters. So yeah, it's the reason to motivate me to become a all-around fighter, because I was a boxing fighter in my beginning. I was used to only one tool. That weapon is my boxing. I used to box my opponent out as soon as possible. But now, I am a MMA fighter, means it's a mixed martial art. So I have to mix a lot of different tools, a lot of different weapons in a fight. So now I'm not only good at boxing, I also good at wrestling, I also good at ground fighting. That is all because I have to face, I have to fight all different kind of fighting style opponents. So yeah, now I'm a update version of Jing, of Panda, a real mixed martial art fighter, a truly mixed martial art fighter.
Yeah, I mean, the growth and the improvement is evident seemingly fight to fight. And it seems like the atomweight title is also something you would like to pursue again, per some articles I was reading, and just in the context of growth and improving, like we're talking about, is there anything different you would do in your preparations should you get another atomweight title fight as compared to when you initially got that atomweight title crack against Angela Lee?
啊，进来，因为其实记者说他已经在很多地方都看，很多地方有读到那个采访文章哦，看到你是有兴趣去原子量级做比赛的，然后还要跟那个李胜珠再来打一场哦。那你觉得如果你去原子量级的话，你会有什么样不同的准备吗？那你什么时候要去原子量级呢？准备肯定是有啦，不仅你的体重要往下降的情况下，而且你还要保证在你 体重降到那个原子量级的级别的同时，还要保证你的身体是，和你的状态都是最佳的。然后，更多的是你可能是在这个基础上，应该是更全面的去备战，去展现自己一些不同的技术。
Okay. Yes, of course, I want to go to the atomweight because I almost clear out my division, you know, the whole strawweight girls, I almost clear out all of them. So I really want to move down to atomweight in the future. It's a near future, not the far future. So I have been thinking about maybe I have to lose some weight from now on, but it's also a very difficult part because, you know, the weight cut sometimes is so hard for a fighter because you have to keep, you have to be healthy in the same time, and losing weight, it's a very difficult part, and you have to keep your muscle or not lose your muscle during the whole weight cut process. So I think a lot of the preparation I have to do when I move down to atomweight, but I'm willing to do that because a lot of amazing fighters in atomweight, like Angela Lee, and don't forget Stan Fairfax. So yeah, I'm looking forward to the fight, no matter if it's Angela Lee or Stan Fairfax.
I was going to say that segues fairly well into my next question. So Zhang doesn't necessarily have a preference between fighting Angela Lee in a rubber match versus, say, fighting Stamp Fairtex for the atomweight title. Should she end up winning that fight, like, no preference between either opponent?
Okay.那你会觉得说，如果你今天去原子量级的话，你会比较想要打李胜珠。 虽然说你两个都想打，李胜珠跟Stamp你都想打，但你更想打是哪一个？或许有一个前后的顺序吗？你要不要打？没有什么想打不想打，我找到了那个级别，我谁都要打。Okay, if I have to say that, yeah, I want to fight Angela Lee, I want to fight Stamp Fairfax, but to be honest, I want to fight all of the girls in atomweight. I want to clear out the atomweight division too.
Yeah, always good to have those different goals, but Jean kind of mentioned something interesting just with the desire to go to atomweight and just trying to be aware of, like, maintaining her strength all throughout. I was also seeing from some articles that she initially started out as a competitive weightlifter, and obviously very different sports in many regards, but just in the sense of, I guess, the musculature, keeping your muscle tissue healthy, stuff like that. Was there any benefits that the weightlifting gave to what she's doing presently now within MMA?
Okay, you mean when if you want to move down to atomweight, how to keep her strength and muscle, right?
Yeah, just like maintaining the musculature, crossing over and everything.
OK，进来，因为提也提到说，如果你要降重到原子量级的话，其实 像你的那个身体状况，刚刚提到嘛，身体状况嘛，还有你的力量嘛，都要保持好。那你现在有没有做什么比较特别准备，让你在降重的过程比较顺利一点？
目前我还真没有想这个呀，因为是现在我把我所有的注意力都用在了我现在的备战当中。突然你今天问我，我可能会不知道。对，我因为我现在没有想这个原因，是因为我现在备战，我只想把我眼前的事情先去做掉，然后再去。好，OK，OK，我懂了。
Hey man, I just want to say that I'm focusing on my Friday night fight right now. So yes, I've been thinking about a move down to atomweight, but about the muscle part, about the strength part, I'll maybe leave it to Saturday after Friday night. I defend my belt. So yeah, I'm just focusing on my fight, on the heavy hitters fight right now.
Yeah, all about the next task coming up. Question, I suppose. Tiffany To Meng Bo, obviously a big fight on the card. Xiong very focused on her own fight, but I mean, I imagine the winner of that one would be the next challenger. Is that something Xiong kind of sees as well? Like maybe that Tiffany To Meng Bo winner being that next strawweight contender?
Oh, okay. I got it. I totally got it. Thank you, Dylan. Okay, Jing Nan, 你现在听得到吗, Jing Nan?
听得到，你说。
OK， 太好了，不好意思，因为刚太吵，所以就没听清楚这个问题。就是刚记者很好奇，有一题，因为现在孟博已经升到了那个，就是你的量级嘛，所以其实真的很多记者都太关心这个问题了。就是你要不要跟孟博，如果这一次 Tiffany 跟那个孟博啊，其中有一个人赢的话，他们可能要再跟你打了。那你 OK 吗？如果跟孟博打的话？
当然 OK， 但是先问他有这个资格打没？我不懂他们赛事是怎么安排的，无所谓，我 I don't care.
Okay, Jing Nan said that she doesn't care. No matter either Tiffany Tao or Meng Bo win the fight on Friday night, no matter who win the fight, she will fight either of them. So it's okay. No matter it's Meng Bo or no matter it's Tiffany Tao again.
Okay. All right. Is there anything Xiong would want to add as a parting thought as we're wrapping up?
Okay.
今天最后有没有一些话想跟粉丝讲的，关于这礼拜五晚上的比赛，还有没有什么其他的事情？你说？希望所有的人能够关注进来，也希望更多的人能够再次知道我训练的中国力量，然后也谢谢大家以来对我的支持和爱护。我也会像你们爱我一样爱你们。谢谢。
I love Jing Nan said that I love all my fans. I thank you for all your support all the time, all this long period, even though I'm in Singapore right now. So I promise I will put on a very great show on Friday night. I will definitely rock the cage, rock the circle. I'll knock Miura-san out. So in a very amazing fashion. So sit tight, enjoying the show.
You heard it there, Ayaka Miura and Xiong Jing Nan testing skills inside the circle January 14th at One Heavy Hitters, and the One Strawweight Championship is up for grabs.